Svalbard was awesome. So, as I mentioned in one of my recent videos, I'd just been to Svalbard. Naturally, I took a lot of film and photography, which I want to share with you. Most of this is filmed with the Sony A7S, but I also took a lot of footage with the iPhone 6S and a Canon 6D. So, to travel to Svalbard, we had to take the plane from Oslo Airport to Tromsø, and then further to Longyearbyen. We arrived safe and sound. Except one thing.
Okay, so we just arrived at Svalbard, and our luggage is gone. So, we're kind of unsure what to do right now, but we'll find a solution.
We were now stuck at Svalbard without any of our winter clothes. And because it was during the Easter holiday, all of the stores had already closed. But then something happened.
Okay, so the store was able to open especially for us. So now we're looking for clothes.
We were actually genuinely impressed of how incredibly helpful and positive everyone was. And because we obviously had travel insurance, everything worked out great.
The insurance company gave us some money, so we were able to buy brand new clothes. Woo!
So with brand new clothes, it was time for our first adventure, the ice caverns of Lars Glacier. It was a really steep climb to get to the entrance, and all the way up it was freezing cold. But as soon as we entered, it was totally worth it. Unfortunately, we were not able to take any film or photos due to heavy condensation on the lenses. But here's a photo of what it looks like. The next morning, it was time for another adventure. Driving snowmobiles across Svalbard. So, after a quick course and putting on special snowsuits, we drove into the winter wilderness. It was an incredible experience, and as I was driving through the winter landscape, it felt almost like I was a part of a big Hollywood movie. But then, something happened.
Okay, we're now actually stuck in the ice, so the scooter is actually a little under the ice. The glacier has pressured some water, but we're having a little rescue operation right now.
So it's going to be
okay.
Apparently, an extremely rare phenomenon had occurred where a nearby glacier had pressured out a lot of ice water, which we happened to drive over. It was a bit of a hassle, but after a couple of hours with heroic effort from our tour guides, we finally got loose and continued on our journey. We were extremely lucky with the weather, with a clear blue sky and a sun which made the landscape look even more spectacular. It's hard to explain in words exactly how beautiful it really was. And remember that the camera only captures a small part of it. So believe me, it was magnificent. The next day, we had a little more time in the morning. So we went out to further explore the town of Longyearbyen. There's actually little more than 2,000 people living here, but the center is still flourishing with life, people, activities, stores, and restaurants. Also, there were a lot of snowmobiles. There's probably more snowmobiles on Svalbard than people. In addition, one more thing there was plenty of were huskies, which brings us to our next adventure. We were picked up at our hotel and driven to the outlying part of Longyearbyen. There lied a huge dog park full of huskies eager to run. So after a quick course, we got paired up and given each our own sled. And once again, it was an incredible experience. yet again, we were incredibly lucky with the weather, and it was a real joy to see the incredibly excited dogs and how much they loved to run. As soon as we took a short stop, they started barking and wanted to go running again. And even though it obviously didn't went as fast as the snowmobiles, you felt more in touch with nature and that you were following the traditions of Arctic explorers, such as Roald Amundsen and Fridtjof Nansen. As a final bonus, the Huskies were extremely sweet and cozy, and we even got to see their puppies.
We'll put one dog at the front, and we'll constantly...
Then came our last day on Svalbard. We had to travel pretty early, so there wasn't much time for activities. But as soon as we stepped outside the hotel, we realized how incredibly lucky we had been with the weather. The temperature had dropped dramatically, and instead of a blue sky, it was cloudy and foggy, with snow blowing in the cold wind. After a little waiting at the airport, we stepped into the plane and went back home. All in all, Svalbard is a magical place. If you want to experience something truly unique and travel somewhere really exotic, this is a destination I can highly recommend. Just remember to bring a lot of warm clothes, because it gets really cold, even for us Norwegians. Okay, thank you for watching. I hope you liked it. I was actually going to publish this a little earlier, but I've been so busy with work and studies and freelance that I had to take a little extra time. But I can assure you that I have a ton of ideas for YouTube films. So even though I sometimes take a little extra time, I promise I will always continue making films and share them with you. Finally, if you want to, you can follow me in social media, all of which I go by the name Eskil Force.